Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome back to Country Cuz Show here on the Sunday Report. And today's Groundhog Day, so I want to wish each and every one of y'all a happy Groundhog Day today. It's also 02/02/2020, so we got a lot of zeros and twos in our date on today's date. But anyway, I watched Positonic Phil up in Pennsylvania this morning, and anyway, he predicted that we're going to have an early spring. I guess maybe that means he saw his shadow. I forget one way or the other, but anyway, I sure hope that little fella's right, because I'm ready for an early spring, and I'm ready to get out and plant a garden. What about y'all? Anyway, today I've got a light on in this room. It may be still a little dark, but something's happened to my music room and the room adjoining it. There's a short, and I've got no electricity in here. And I am running a light from up in the living room on the drop cord, but our kitchen's working, so we'll survive till I figure it out. I changed out all the electrical recepts yesterday and all the switches, and that didn't help. Flipped the fuse on, or the breaker, it's a 15 amp breaker, and give it a minute and pow, it'll pop off. So they's a dead short somewhere. Anyway, I'm messing around with it now. I reckon I'm gonna start working on the lights, see if there's a wire broke. Might even have to end up going under the house, which I dread. But anyway, what I wanted to show y'all today is I've got some lap steels I'm working on, and this is I've got two burnt wood series right here. This one is one I built the other day, 184, but this one over here in the very back is the hobo series I built, and I'm gonna try to get up there in the line. It's a beautiful lap steel also, but I had sold this lap steel to a gentleman. Never did he learn how to play, so I did some trading and got it back because I know what I had in it and I know what it would do. So it's a very, very great, capable lap steel of playing with anybody's lap steel out there on the market. This one does not, like the rest of them, I didn't put a volume knob or a tone knob. In fact, I don't think none of those do, because I use a volume pedal on my playing, and I'll show you if y'all stand by. Right here is one of the better ones for steel, lap steel, because it don't require no electricity. It's got, you can plug a tuner in right here, and then you got a input and output, and it's got a pot in it, just like a guitar. It rolls up and down with a geared cable, very smooth, works great. It's a Dunlap low function brand drive, but what I like about it is the whole function of it all the way down decreases the sound. Well, that would be opening it up and roll it back to decrease the sound and then go wide open. But there's a lot of in between on this volume pedal. Now I've got a Leonard Marley digital volume pedal, and that volume pedal has to be plugged to electricity. But I'm going to turn around and show you another guitar. I got this one back too. That was the Orange Harley Davidson series style. Beautiful guitar here. It's orange, and it's got a fretboard on it that is vinyl inlays over the top. I had to put it on the board itself. Also, it's got a humbucker pickup in it. It's got my fully adjustable bridge and saddle, and I do put that on all of them I build now, because the first ones I built, I just had a nut like this, kind of like the Recording Kings and the SXs. Just can't adjust the darn things by here, so when you can't adjust the lap steel, you can't make the bar flat. Anyway, I got that one and that one, and I got one more, and I can't play them because unless I go up to the kitchen and my wife might skin me up. But here's the John Deere green one, and this paint on it is actually a little bit brighter than the real John Deere green color. I didn't use their color. That way they can't cram a copyright on me. So I went with a different color green, but it is in the neighborhood. Humbucker pickup in this one too. Fully adjustable saddle on it. Ready to roll. Got my heavy gauge springs on all of them. So anyway, oh boy, I've been working on this electrical stuff and I'm about wore out from it, folks, I guarantee you. But I appreciate each and every one of you coming up to the show today. I've also got a, I'm fixing to start selling off some of my guitars, I tell you. After running through all this electrical trouble, I had all these guitar cases and guitars in the bedroom back there, and we had to move them all out to the living room. And I looked down and I told my wife, I didn't even realize I had found guitars under the bed that's been there. I got a one from 1970 Telecaster. That's the first guitar I ever bought. Was a Mocha Brown Fender Telecaster, 1970. I think brand new, it was $300. And I bought a Fender Twin Amp, and it was so heavy I eventually sold it and bought a PV Amp that was lighter. Wish I'd have kept the old Fender Twin, but you know, that's hindsight. Anyway, I got a pile of guitars I'm going to be showing them. So y'all stay tuned to the channel and we'll go to digging in my guitar pile. And I'm going to put them on reverb, you know, and that right now I've got some fine instruments on reverb. Martins, Taylors, and some Deering banjos, and I've got one I'm going to video or shoot today. And I'm not playing them, I'm just taking pictures, but y'all check it out. I'll put a link to this on this video. You go below, you can go to my reverb channel, check out the gear I'm selling, and I may come up with some effect pedals. And I got a large collection, I mean very large collection, of brand new books on how to play different instruments, mandolins, banjos, guitars, ukuleles, fiddles, violin. I got a fiddle too I'm going to put up for sale because I don't play the fiddle. So y'all stay tuned, and if you're not a subscriber to the Country Cuz channel here, go right down there and click that. Wow, there it is right here. The little red box right below my left foot here, right there. Y'all click on that and you'll be a subscriber. Hit that bell for notification. Now I'll put a link to that. And then the next time I do a report here, I hope we have electricity, and also I'm gonna let y'all in on the secrets of making money with your music. My contract's running out in February, and this is February because today's Groundhog Day, so I think about the 15th is when it runs out. If I don't get it renewed by then, I'll tell y'all all about it. I guarantee you. Country Cuz, everybody be safe out there, and I hope it ain't snowing too hard where you at. We got beautiful sunshine, 39 degrees or so, but we're supposed to warm up to 62 or 3 today, so I hope I can get out of the house for a while and do some rambling, maybe go out of my shop, straighten it up, get ready to start building some lap steel guitars. Anyway, y'all come back to see us here. Thank you very much.